Hey, this is Peter from Next on Web. In today's video, we're going to talk about loading speed. I will show you the optimization options of Smart Slider and give you suggestions on how to use them. You can test the speed of your website on Google PageSpeed Insights. The speed score affects Google search ranking, so try to reach the best score you can get. Make sure to check both the mobile and desktop results. If you scroll lower, you can see the metrics of speed. These are important milestones on your loading timeline. For example, when did the first big content appear? Or, when was the website visitor able to click anywhere? These will define your overall score. But you should know that Slider is just part of the whole page. Your website has much more content on it, so the entire optimization cannot be based on Smart Slider only. I have a page with mostly just this slider on it. For a speed test, you don't necessarily have to go to Google PageSpeed Insights. You can also use your Chrome browser. Just right-click on the page and choose Inspect. This opens up Chrome's Developer Tools, which has a Lighthouse tab. Press Generate Report to see the result of the selected tests. My score is 78, which isn't the worst, but I'll show you some options which can improve it. Go to the Slider Settings, to the Optimize tab. This tab contains most of the optimization options you can use. Let's start with Loading Type. When your slider is on top of the page, choose Instant to make it load as fast as possible. But when your slider is lower, choose After Page Load. This way, the slider will let your other content load first. The Loading Mode defines how your background images are loading. With lazy loading, a background image only loads when you switch towards its slide. As you can see, in my loading timeline, new images only appear upon slide switching. Convert to WebP creates WebP images from your backgrounds. You can set default, medium, and small image sizes for the new pictures. Most browsers support WebP images. We use the original image as fallback for those devices which don't support it. As you can see, my images are too big. Large images load slower. This is why they need to be resized. Also, the WebP images have smaller file size, so they can load even faster. I don't have thumbnails now, but if you do, you can resize them as well. The layer images have the same optimization options. The Base64 Embed option turns your small images into part of the page's HTML. This helps, because usually the server's waiting time takes the longest part of the loading. While the actual loading time of the image is quite fast. By turning your images into HTML codes, you can eliminate the waiting time. But this only works well for small images. Big images can increase the page size too much, and make it load even slower than without the Base64 embedding. The last setting on the Optimize tab allows you to turn off background videos for mobile phones. There are no videos on this slider, so I leave this option enabled. After these settings are done, we can save them and move on to the first slide. Take a look at the first text. Enter the Style tab, where you can find the font family of the layer. Every Google font needs to load its own file, so my design isn't really good, as I used different font families for each layer. If you can, use the same font family for all your texts. Let's go back to the Slider Settings page. Here you can enter the global settings, which are affecting all your sliders. Go to the Framework tab. Here you can find a Header Preload option. If sliders have important roles on your pages, turn this option on to prioritize them over other contents. Now that all optimizations are done, take a look at Lighthouse once again. Go to its tab and press Generate Report. Much better! I hope the slider optimization will help your website as well. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, and if you would like to see more videos in the future, subscribe. Have a nice day!